Hey Trey, how are you? Hopefully you can hear me, okay? I don't think the music's too loud. You still, yeah, I actually still didn't get it last night. Managed to get my curved bow, which is nice. I got it. So my kill log on Runelite is 890. I think I did maybe 25 kills on mobile, so just below 1,000, I think, which is very nice. I'm so glad I got it sooner rather than later. It just means now that I've actually got to train cooking rather than getting it naturally. But it won't take long. Hopefully, we'll do a roll during this stream, which would be good. Good to see what killer grind I get put into next. Hopefully should be about maybe an hour and a half away from rolling, I think. So, 1,600 actions, and normally you can cook about 1.4K, I think. Hey Soda, thank you very much. I see you and Armadillo have been absolutely smashing the levels today. I think you both got 600 total level, didn't you? Man, you need to release episode 2. I actually really enjoyed the first episode. It's the first group chunk account I've seen, so this is enjoyable to watch. That's good. Which chunk did you roll? Oh, so what's the is there a crafting requirement in that chunk, or have you already got the requirement for that? But I didn't think you needed to do the quest to get in that, get in the dungeon. I must be wrong. Yeah, I've killed a fair few muggers in my time. They're actually a better drop rate for beginner clues, rather than men. I've killed yeah 1200 muggers. And I've got 11 knives in that time, so should be alright. Shouldn't be too much of a grind. Thank you, Daryl. Thank you very much. I was quite excited when I got it. It's just one of those things you just don't expect to get at all. You feel like you're just killing them for no reason, and then all of a sudden it just drops. Hopefully, like I said, it should take me about an hour and a half to get to the next chunk requirement, which is 65 cooking, and then we can do a roll on stream, hopefully. You guys can help me pick out of the two we get. I think towards the end of the cooking, as we get towards 65, I think I'm going to make quite a lot of pizzas. Just so then when we get 65, I can add the pineapples as a good source of food. Assuming we get a chunk that has a bank in it. May as well just set the goal. Hopefully the time on this will be more accurate than what I said earlier. Hopefully it goes down by a lot. I did also get my unofficial goal of 38 farming, and I planted that toadflax seed, if anyone remembers me having that. Everything's coming at once. keep doing that. I keep forgetting to actually buy it. I keep misclicking. I need to change the menu swapper so it's buy. Can't remember what a setting is for that. Yeah, I know. I can't believe I got the curved bone before you got the rune chain. That is crazy. You'll get it tonight, easily. Assuming you're playing tonight. Well, you are. I didn't think you were. Yeah, do it. I'll definitely be watching. I think I'm going to hopefully get to my rolling. Chunk rolling and explore the new chunk and then probably end it and start editing a video, I think. What on earth is Fallout 4 Frost? I've not heard of that. I played Fallout 4 a lot when it first came out, but I've not played it since. Oh wow, that sounds good. Might have to check that out. Yeah, that's a problem with mods. They can be a bit tricky sometimes. Is it not on the like the official mod? I don't know what it's called, like repository on the game. I know they actually allow mods, don't they? Yeah, I think that might be it. I've only played it. Okay. Yeah, that makes sense. I've only ever played it on computer, on console, sorry. It's only because I'm a cheapskate and I have Game Pass, and it's obviously free. Yeah, you're getting unlucky with those, that rune chain, honestly. The point is, you get unlucky with some things and you get absolutely spooned on others, so, you know, it's just annoying that there's a chunk requirement that you get unlucky on. Yeah, I mean, the only other rewards really are Alps, so I'm pretty sure you get, is it the Runefall Helm from them? Or, yeah, there's another rune item, so I guess Alps are nice, but it is a not very easy enemy to kill. But it's just a chain. Oh, and the med, yeah. So it's not even good for Alks then, really. I suppose I was quite lucky with the ice giants that they drop, like herb seeds and stuff. Not that they drop many, but you know, it's an added bonus when I got them. It's crazy. That is absolutely crazy. Plus you got the big coin drop yesterday as well, which I think is rarer than that. It's crazy that you get all these other drops and you don't get the one thing you need. And I'm pretty sure it's actually quite a big upgrade as well, isn't it? There's the Nomi. You want me to pick some air runes up for you, from the shop? That sounds like so much. At least when you get to Viro or whatever you call it, I can't say the proper name. You'll have plenty of keys to give you a good head start. Damn, that's a lot. I've honestly been wasting a lot of my nets. Alkin. I really do wish I kept them. I've got some horrible chunks that could require a very large amount of nature room. Hoping to roll today in about an hour and 20 minutes. I'll be able to roll. Just need 65 cooking. Yeah, it's good. Unlocked some very good food supply. Oh, you're 66. Ugh, I'm not concentrating and I always forget to drop these blooming things. Eventually we're going to hit the 95 requirement for the summer pie, so we'll both be sitting at that stage. I actually don't know, I've not even looked. I don't really want that. I think I must be one or two rolls away as well. Luckily I get to pick one of the two, so I can avoid it a little bit. I think I'm gonna get stuck with a 64 cooking. One more to go. Curious actually which chunk gives me the sum of my requirement. Yeah, so I only need Irish. I think. Oh. I'm just checking out my my chunks around me to see which ones are going to absolutely kill me. I haven't checked many times, but the drainer chunk is going to be mumps, I think. I've got to cut a diamond in that chunk, which would be a bit of a grind. And obviously the wood cutting, fletching, fire making requirements. Almost any chunk I roll, I'm gonna have to get 60 wood cutting, 75 fletching. Or have to mine a lot. So smithing, I can't roll, well I can roll a chunk, but it won't come up with the requirement for 99 smithing, because I have no way of training smithing, because nothing in this chunk drops tin ore, so I can't superheat bronze bars, nothing drops bronze bars, so at the minute I'm safe with that. I think if I roll... I think if I roll the chunk north of Drainer or Falador, obviously, then smithing opens up. I honestly don't know what I'll do if I get to that. I'm hoping I unlock the void outpost before then for an anvil closer to the bank. Yeah, farming is going to be a passive gain. If I roll the farming cape, yeah, Daryl's always in the chat. yeah, if I roll the farming cape, I'll set myself a very high goal, but it won't be 99, because it would just be a complete blocker on the account, and there's no point doing that. There's a hell of a lot to be doing in the drainer chunk anyway, so I'll probably get a high requirement. If Daryl's not in that stream, there's going to be a riot. Yeah, trade. Do you know what? I didn't think of that actually. I could sell these two. And I might get rid of this as well. But to be honest, it's not hard to get back. And I don't think I've got any other combat requirements for a while, so I think that's a very good shout. I think I'll do that now. Yeah, I think I'll just put them in the deposit box. I have been like questioning myself doing it, but yeah, I think I'm just gonna do it. I'll sell this just to get a little bit of money back, if I even can. $2K, that's not bad. Yeah, I roll two, pick one. Purely because of the two chunks I could have rolled right at the beginning, which would be Falador and Drainer, two absolute killer chunks. Luckily, I didn't roll both of them at the same time. Yeah, I've got the Rimington chunk is that's one I really don't want to roll. Really do not want to roll that one. Yeah, thank you, Trey. I think it's definitely going to speed up the process a little bit. An hour left, roughly. Yeah, I don't think I've got any other pick available in the Remington chunk. I really hate the star requirement. Like, it makes like the most randomest chunk just a 90 mining requirement. I have also considered banking my weeds, but they've been with me since the start, and I'm going to hold them until I get a bank available. Yeah, I'm actually just waiting until I get a tinderbox so I can do some magic things with this. It's already wrapped in a paper. Wonder how quickly I get the beaver pet when I unlock on Axe. I wonder how many beaver pets I get. Here's another question. For anyone that doesn't know, I have two Rockies. Yeah, that was a 62 thieving as well, I think. There is something about chunk accounts and early pets. Yeah, it's crazy. Didn't Soda also get the full angler outfit? Like, super early. I know it was Soda. I remember someone watching his, because there's so many, I always forget which it is, but yeah, that's absolutely crazy. That's definitely the lowest. Yeah, definitely Spoon. I reckon it's punishing you, Trey, because you backlogged it. I reckon you're gonna have to get like 10 times the amount. Yeah, the run's doing a lot better. Still have energy now, so it's definitely holding up. Does anyone here play the Discord, like, old school pop? Like, with the minions? Ooh, a dance. I'm so slow at these. It's quite fun. It took me a while to figure out how it works, but yeah, it's quite fun. It's good to just like do every now and again, send off on little trips and stuff. It's good. Mine's currently doing Barrows runs. So I've had two dunces today. Crazy. I get none for weeks, and then all of a sudden I get two in one day. What are you putting yours on now? No. Yeah, you could try something like that, Trey. It sounds like a good idea, to be honest. I don't know what servers have it in. A few seconds, I'll just check. None of the servers I'm on. I've just added it to my personal one. If you're in the Gnomies, I think that has it. It's not his Discord, I don't think. I always thought it was, but it's not. Let me. It's actually Soda's Discord group, I think. I sent you an invite on Discord. Yeah, definitely check his channel. He's got some good videos. He's got a Supreme Chunk Dog account in Port Cazard, I believe. Yeah, it's old school RS soda on YouTube. See you later, Daryl. Thank you for stopping by, as always. We got 30k to go. Get the 10k mark. I'm gonna make pizzas because I kind of want to have a nice little stack of pizzas to make pineapple pizzas with. You got the Rune Chain Body tray. You best tell me you've got it. Is there anything I think you get excited for? Nice. Congrats. Now you didn't quite reach the 3 times the drop rate. You should count yourself lucky. Could have been a lot worse. And like I said earlier, at least you're working for something that is actually an upgrade and not something like a curved bone, which I can do nothing with for many, many, many weeks and months, if ever. Trey, are you gonna stream your junk roll? Oh wait, what tasks have you got left? Is that is cooking one of them, if I remember correctly? Oh, okay, that's not too bad then. Have you got to get the flower from an imp? Or have you already got the flower? And the shield is a bit of a weird one. I guess it depends if it's best in slot for your range, range defense, or magic defense, whatever it is. It's always on my chunk tasks because it's the highest fletching requirement, I think, normally. No, oh, okay. But if you take a bucket with you, isn't there a sink down in the Black Knight's bit? That's like a good food source down there. Yeah, that's a handy little food source down there though. Never known that before. Oh, okay, never mind. Maybe it's not such a good food source then. Yeah, I suppose Black Knights are easy to kill, aren't they? Say you look like a free-to-play range tank Chad. I've looked like a poor, I don't even know what, a poor free-to-play champion. The air tray, that's fine. I think as long as it's a YouTube clip, it'll let you post it in the chat anyway. I'll watch it on my phone, I don't want to blast anyone's ears off. I thank you for subscribing. I really do appreciate that. Yeah, man, you share whatever you want. I don't like, what's it called? Like, I like to share the love. So, much like you. Hairy things again. No, thank you. Honestly, so hyped to see what my next jump is going to be. I reckon you'll get yours before mine. I mean, I'm about 43 minutes away, but that might slow down because of the pizzas at the end. It takes ages to buy them and make them for that matter. Did you send me the link to you reacting? Or have you not posted it yet? Just wondering if it's block the chat without me knowing. Yeah, it must have blocked it because I didn't see it. Didn't see it come up or anything. You'd like to think it would like show me that it blocked something. I don't know if you heard me watching it, but that was brilliant. It's such a good reaction. Anyone would have thought you got like a volatile orb or something. I mean, that's probably the greatest reaction to a rune chain body anyone's heard. I think that should be your new intro. Suck my dick and balls, RuneScape. How do your recording? Do you like record the whole time? Yeah, that's a good intro. I like that. I need to do that. I need to do like a recap. Yeah, how do you do a recording? Do you record all the time, or do you just record when something happens? Yeah, okay, same as me then. Yeah, I don't know how people. Oh, okay. I need to look into a replay buffer. Do you do that via what do you use for that replay buffer? No. Is that the Nvidia thing? Streamlabs OBS. What streaming software do you use? Oh, yeah, OBS. Okay. I definitely need to look into that then. I think after that, after this stream, I'm gonna look into that. Yeah, because I use OBS, and I'm pretty confident of OBS now, so I'm not gonna change. But I didn't realize they had a shadow play function. Or a replay buff, or whatever you want to call it. Yeah, that's fine. Well, I mean, the good thing is, RuneScape doesn't take up much memory anyway, so. I guess it's not really an issue with recording this, but if you're recording, if I try it on a more intensive game, I'm probably gonna have issues. Especially it would sound like jet engines starting. Yeah. I know sometimes when I record on my I play a lot on my Surface Pro. Obviously I don't stream on that. But when I re start recording on there, it probably gets like really loud. Yeah, you're gonna get it before me, I think, Trey. It's always nice to kill monsters that actually have good Good drops. He's made some serious progress since his third episode. I'm almost annoyed that I actually have to grind cooking for this. I was purely expecting to get 65 cooking, like naturally getting the curved spoon. I really wasn't expecting to have to cook sardines again. Yeah, I cook at a pizza. I do have access to it in the box. The tinderbox isn't the problem though, it's the axe that's the problem. Or the logs, should I say. Are you thinking about setting up a fire here to make it easier? Thank you. sure I did actually just before you said that, I thought, oh, I could just get another account to make fires. It's okay. If I thought about that about four levels ago, I probably might have done, but I think I just carry on with this now. I'm not far off. And when I start doing the pizzas soon anyway, and I'd need a range for that. Good luck, bro. Hopefully it doesn't take too long. Thank you. time to do some pizzas. So, according to the calculator, I only need to do 70 pizzas. But I will probably burn a few. So let's go for 10, 10. Let's just do 70, 25. It's a very tedious process making this many without having a bank. Looks like someone's been buying the pot of flour. How dare they? Such a tedious process. This is such a tedious process, honestly. I hate it. I think I'm just gonna do this inventory and go back to sardine. We did 24. That is still a nice amount of XP. Let's see how many we burn. Did you put in yours, Trey? I burnt one, which isn't too bad. Now, I want to be careful here because I do actually want to keep one out. Oh, you still haven't got the flour yet. Fair enough. Well, I'm gonna keep that pizza there. I'm gonna finish up the sardines because it just takes so long. Yeah. I mean, the cooking XP is nice, but it's just such a long, drawn out process making it. Yeah, see you later. No, yeah, thank you very much, mate. Thank you very much for joining the stream. I appreciate it. I suppose one benefit to having to flinch the ice giants at the end is that I didn't have to spend all my money on runes, which means I had enough money to buy all this fish, which is good. Means I would have had to pick guards to get the money to buy all this fish. So yeah, it saved me time, to be honest. So close. I can smell my new chunk. we go, last inventory. There we go, that is 65 cooking. I can now make pineapple pizzas. And that is the last requirement for this chunk. So let's go ahead and make this pineapple pizza. I don't actually know. I think it's Daiso, isn't it? Yeah, let's do that. I'm gonna make it a pizza. There we go. Pineapple pizza. Actually, a very, very good source of food. Now, we need to figure out what chunk we're going to. So, give me a second to get this. Get this all set up. Yeah, I think it is 22 points. I remember looking and it's definitely better than sharks, so yeah, it must be 22 points, which is really good, really good food. It's just a shame it's a pain in the ass to make. So we have quite a lot of available ones to pick. Basically all of the ports. We've got Zaya over here that we could unlock. We've got Catherby. I'd actually really like this port. I'd really like this one. What's that? Oh, that's Entrana. I really don't want Entrana. But it is on there. I'm not sure, you might be able to help me, whether I can actually go to this charter ship. Because it's inside Port of Pasmatis. I think I have to have completed, what's the one that gets you through? I don't actually know what chunk tasks it has. Wear rune armor. Oh, it's got greater demons down there. That'd be nice. Baked tuna potato. A Priest in Peril, that's it, yeah. Yeah, and Trino would be a rough unlock, unfortunately. It's not too bad, to be honest. Let's just roll. I'm stalling because I don't want any bad ones, but yeah, let's just roll. Hopefully this pops up in right in the center, but we'll see. So, okay, so we've got Port Cazard. I am recording here. We've got Port Cazard or Drainer. Oh. This is. Drainer is a bad boy chunk. So we've got the fletching and all the woodcutting requirements, fire making requirements, but that's standard across pretty much every single chunk I'm going to get now. But it also comes with the minor tier 9 shooting star. It enables me to start smithing as well. Hasn't got it on here, but I will have to obtain. Oh, I don't know if I can even start fishing, actually. Because you have to have a certain level to start it, I think. The shooting star is really putting me off. Because of super heat. It's got, hang on. It's got copper and tin rocks there, I think. Yeah. So, because I've got super heat unlocked, I can do that. Fifteen fishing, okay. Yeah, I'm at 10 already. The 90 mining requirement though puts me off big style. Yeah, true. True. I think I'm. Yeah. Let's see what Drainer has. Wish I could make this bit bigger, but I can't. Wield a steel warhammer. The farming cape is going to get backlogged. I'm not doing that. There's basically fletching, wood cutting, a little bit of fishing. Smith a bullseye lantern. Bullseye lighting is 49 smithing. Oh god. Okay. Cut a diamond. That's rough. No, it's steel, unfortunately. Oh, it's good. So you can make you dye capes. So I would have to dye capes up until hang on, let me just check my crafting on the other screen. So I would have to dye capes until I can do. until I'd have to dye capes until 20. Yeah, 43 crafting for diamonds. I really don't know, man. These are two killer chunks. I feel like Port Khazad is going to be better. Hey, thank you, Dwarf King. I'm just trying to decide between the two. Oh, you got the flour. Well done. Go make that pizza. Turof King, I might need your help, man. I got Draenor or Port Khazad. I use the extreme rule set, so essentially my choice, I've got to get 49 smithing and 43 crafting here. So I have to dye capes until level 20. Yeah, that's a passive requirement, that's nothing to worry about, to be honest. There's nothing I can do for gems. It's all random drop table. Because if I pick this chunk as well, I can't even do the star. Yeah, that's crazy. That's absolutely crazy. That's mumps. I feel like that's mumps. The only thing that's putting me off Port Khazad is the 90 mining requirement with a bronze pickaxe. If it actually loads, I think I've crashed it now. Everything else in that chunk is quite good. It gives me a bank. They both give me a bank. There's a lot. Yeah, 43 crafting in 12. I don't know why it does this. I think I'm gonna go. No, I already have a diamond. And it's actually a requirement, so I think it does. Something must drop it. It's literally nothing. It's not even. Yeah. What level is 43 crafting? That's 50,000 XP, so I'd have to die 25,000 capes. Well, 20,000 capes, sorry. I ain't about that lifestyle. I think I'm going to go Port Khazad. I think that's... It's the cape that's the problem, isn't it? I don't know. Is the onion... Is the onion spawn in... Is the onion filled in that chunk? Yeah, I think we're forgetting about the fact that I've got to get 49 smithing as well. That's a lot of nature runes. I just feel like the only bad thing in this chunk is the star. But the other chunk has many bad things. I know. You can't even make pickaxes, can you? You can't smith them. So, just to put it in perspective, 90 mining is 152,000 iron ores. If the only way of obtaining onions is growing them, then yes, 100% mining is going to be faster. I wasn't even aware of like the whole dying cape thing. Yeah, I can do red berries, but that means I have to go to this shop and buy out red berries every time. That's what I thought as well. I don't, on the map it doesn't show it. Doesn't show it on the map. Yeah, red berries. Buying 20,000 red berries from that shop. Jesus. I suppose it wouldn't really be 20,000 though, because I do get gems. So it would reduce in time. It's okay. Well, apparently you can dye the same cape. Oh, it's three red berries each. So that's 60,000 red berries I'd have to buy from that shop. And it only stocks one. I'm doing it, guys. I'm doing Khazad. I'm going to unlock that. Done. It's done. Oh, let me show you. Sorry, I had it on the other screen. Yeah, I've unlocked it. Well, we might have that grind soon, but I'm gonna go for the mining grind, I think. And like you said, I'm gonna lamp hunter and hope for a mithril pickaxe. Because if I'm not mistaken, I can actually get crafting XP on the ship for the minigame. I guess we should go and have a look. See what's popping. I think another thing that kind of persuaded my mind there was the whole cape situation. I feel like I would get horribly burnt out doing the capes. At least with mining, you can kind of switch things up a little bit. Here we go, let's go. Port Khazad. I have to make sure I keep that amount of coins in the bank just so I can come back. Make sure we unlock. I know. I'll be honest, that kind of persuaded my mind as well. I've been looking forward to having a mini game in my chunk. Something that I can actually enjoy. Probably won't enjoy it for very long though, but there we go. So here we are. We've got the sword trader over there, which won't give me any. Is it? I think it's just a mithril sword. If it's an Adi sword, then it will give me an upgrade. But yeah, we got the mini game here. Fishing trawler. A trawler net. Oh, we've got a bank. We'll save that for a bit. We're gonna do the big reveal of what's in my bank. because I've not actually seen it. We've got the shopkeeper. We've now got an axe. And we've got a pickaxe. Yeah, let's buy them now. They're going to be the bane of my life. We got planks for when we unlock Rimington. Might start collecting these now. Save myself time in the future. We've got some rocks down there. What does this guy sell? Oh, I think it's just another general store. Do we know if we can sell things to this shop? Exactly. There is a lot of unlocks on this chunk. I've got to do wood cutting, mining, fletching. Let's go this way first. Compost heap. So we've got an oak log there. We've got trees. And any questions about that? If I can access it from my chunk, it's accessible. I know there was arguments in Soda's thing about that, but if it's accessible from my chunk, as long as I don't have to leave the chunk to access it, then I should be able to use it. So we've got plenty of iron here, some myth, tin and clay. Oh, is that clay? Ooh, clay. Hey, well done, Trey. Congrats. I'll end my stream in a minute, and if you're streaming your role, I'll come and watch. Let's have a look in the bank. There's not really much else here. Let's check out the bank. Oh my goodness, look at all those herbs. I'm gonna have to spend some time sorting this out. We've got quite a lot of sapphires already, to be honest. Some runes. 10 onions. Got quite a lot of seeds. 3 long bones I got in that grind, which is under drop rate, and 1 curved bone. That juicy curved bone. So there we go. Yeah, I know, yeah. That's probably the first thing I'm going to do, to be honest. But yeah, thank you very much for joining the stream, guys. Hell, there we go. Here's a quick starter for fletching. I've got all those feathers. And I've got a steel axe. Yeah. What is my playtime, actually? 9 days and 13 hours. 9 days and 13 hours to unlock my fourth chunk. I can tell you now, that's probably about average or below a lot of other chunk, extreme chunk accounts. Purely because I've had some easy rolls. I know Turok King definitely is over that, and is still on the first chunk. Yeah, I'm gonna carry on Lamping Hunter. What is it? Eclectic implants, isn't it? That gives it. So let's have a look what we need. That one. Barehanded. Okay. I don't think I'll be Lamping Hunter for level 60. Yeah, and come join your stream. I'm just going to shift my butt upstairs, probably. Oh yeah, true, very true. Right, thank you very much for joining my stream, guys. I very much appreciate the likes and the views. And I guess look out for my episode 3. I need to edit it. But thank you very much. And I'll see you later, guys. Thank you.